Well, here's Kurt Browning, disappointed by his fourth place standing after the technical program. We'll see a new program here tonight, and definitely a new look.
Well, speaking of risks, meet Rag-Gidon the Clown.
The amount of work that went into it, but as a skater, there's nothing more terrifying than attempting a program like this, starting a program like this in center ice in front of 12,000 plus people who expect you to be funny and thinking to yourself, Oh my goodness, I hope they laugh.
And standing there with a red nose, you have no choice.
But he is a chameleon. He pulls everything off, doesn't he?
I can't tell you how difficult this program is, because landing the jumps on the notes that we chose, working on the subtleties, holding to the character, all that detail is just so hard to perform.
I
don't know anybody else who could do it.
I have one question. Is the program over?
Obviously not. I had no part in this.
They're going to get him off the ice. Just when you think you've seen it all from Kurt Browning, he gives you something else and something special.
I just love it when a program...
Strong little guy.
...captures your imagination so brilliantly.
We were afraid of this when we started working on it, and we knew how risky it was, but...
That was awesome! I loved your movie!
I loved your nickel.
Really?
Well, the early returns are good.
I mean, in order to sustain a professional career, you do have to take chances, and sometimes they work and sometimes they don't, but it sure is sweet when they do.
5.8. The technical marks up to a 5.9 from the Italian judge.
And those marks are fair. They're low, but they're fair. He did not land all his jumps as cleanly as he could.
Some of the fans don't think those marks are fair, but look at this. Presentation marks. And sixes from the United States, from Canada, from Poland, and from Russia. That'll make the skater feel pretty good, and probably the choreographer too.
Rag-Gidon is undefeated. He wins here tonight to let Kurt finish second. And how did it feel to get out there in front of this house and pull off such a risky number?
It's a friendly risk. It's it is risky, and I got a little nervous before it started because I didn't feel the momentum yet. So I'm like, just trust the program. The program is good, and it proved itself in Canada. And by the end, everyone was into Raggy, I guess. It seemed even and more incredibly risky when we're in the rink by ourselves making it up. Is this funny?
And making it up is what type of process for this particular type of number?
It's show and tell.
It's show and tell. He would do something and I would stand back and say...
Now that's funny.
Now that's funny. Mm-hmm. And then I would do something and he would stand back...
That's
and,
really funny.
And go, that's, or he'd burst out laughing and say, no, we can't use that.
Yeah.
It was trial and error. I mean, we really spent sometimes 2 hours on 10 seconds.
5 or 6 different endings.
Yes. But then we found it.
Now, you've won this event before. You know how difficult it is to win here. Is it the most challenging event of the season?
Oh, yeah. This is my peak, you know. And, it hurts even more knowing that I could have won it with just even a couple of triples last night. And but that's what you got to do. You can't come here and make mistakes and lose. I mean, and win. And so I've had a good run and won this 3 times, and I got beat by the world champion. And I got beat by myself, too.